When you travel the world, you're bound to run into some unfamiliar, but hopefully delicious cuisine. Some countries take their food to the extreme, though. Join us as we travel across the globe to check out some of the strangest Japanese foods. Bashashi. Now let's begin our list with a little thing called basashi, which is hard for me to even say. It translates to horse meat. You can find this beloved delicacy in many Japanese restaurants, served sashimi style with soy sauce, garlic, and or Japanese horseradish. Now, if you want some of the best horse sushi out there, you'll want to pay a visit to Kumamoto, which is found on the island of Kyushu. Now, despite the ick and the emotional factors at play here, those that eat this dish claim that it has incredible health benefits. Research also suggests that those who eat a lot of it live longer, much longer than their non-horse-eating counterparts. And if that's not enough to sell you on eating raw horse meat, consider this. Horse has a whole lot more protein, as well as fewer calories and less fat than beef or pork. Uni. Not into horse meat sushi? Well, that's okay. We've got lots of other delicious Japanese foods to introduce you to. However, if you're not a seafood lover, chances are that uni is not for you. Uni is Japanese speak for the innards of a sea urchin. You know, those spiky little black critters that hang out in the ocean? More specifically, uni is sea urchin sperm and or eggs. Wow, delicious. Those who have been brave enough to try it say that it's smooth and creamy and has a sweet yet briny taste. Just like the horse meat, it's served sushi or sashimi style. And though it's disgusting to many, it's a Japanese delicacy that's increasing in popularity across the world. However, if you do want to try authentic Japanese uni, you may have to hurry, because researchers say that sea urchins are dying left and right in Japan due to environmental changes. These include runoff, along with increased water acidity and temperatures. So, just make sure that you get to them while you can. Or not. I don't really care what you eat. Shirako. Enter Shirako, aka fish sperm. But don't write it off so quickly, because if you like caviar or even fish eggs, you may just enjoy Shirako, as it's essentially the male fish equivalent of caviar. Now, usually it's extracted from the pufferfish, the anglerfish, or cod. Shirako has a creamy and buttery texture with a soft tofu-like flavor, depending on the way that it's prepared. You can get it poached, fried, grilled, or even raw, and you don't even need to go to Japan. However, a simple grilled fish sperm sack could cost an upwards of $100 in the United States. So you may just be better off hopping on a plane and getting the real deal. Dancing squid. Now, I know that you've seen viral videos of this Japanese dish floating around the interwebs, but I'm here to bust a myth that surrounds the strange and controversial Japanese food. First of all, the critters that you see featured in these odd-looking meals, whether actual squid or cuttlefish, are in fact dead. However, when you pour soy sauce over the sea creature, it appears to come alive. The reason is because the squid is so fresh that the muscles are still reactive. And the salt in the soy sauce causes an automatic reaction that makes it appear as if the squid has come alive again. In fact, if your squid begins dancing off the table, you can rest assured that it's the freshest that you can ever get. You know, if you can catch it, that is. Kujira wa uruka. Speaking of controversial food, how about kujira wa uruka, otherwise known as whale meat? This traditional dish has roots in the early 1900s when Japan could not afford to import meats from other countries. And at the time, due to the large whale population, they decided that whale meat would be the best sustainable resource for protein. The belly of the whale was often sliced up bacon style, while the tail was usually prepared as sashimi or fried and covered in a delicious sauce. Even though they do catch a lot of flack for it, some Japanese people still indulge in this forbidden fruit of the sea, saying that it tastes like deer or moose and that it takes on a gamey flavor. In addition, the belly and the tail meat actually have fewer calories and less fat than heart attack-inducing pork and beef. Namako. By now, it shouldn't really surprise you that the Japanese love seafood. But did you know they also enjoy a great sea cucumber now and again? Also called the sea slug, or namako, these critters are often served raw in Japanese restaurants. Rumor has it they're just as appealing as a garden cucumber. You know, tasteless and boring. To properly prepare a sea cucumber, you first must soak it in water and then remove all the entrails. And like your typical cucumber, it's a healthy food option. Not only do they have cancer-fighting properties, but they also contain much-needed nutrients like vitamins A, B1, B2, and B3, as well as zinc, iron, and magnesium, which is probably why many Asian cultures use these sea critters to treat a lot of different ailments. Are they gross? Well, yeah, a little bit, but the health benefits might outweigh the egg factor. With that being said, sea cucumber anyone? Natto. Now, if you're in Japan and looking for a healthy breakfast option, you're likely going to stumble across natto. Even though it does look like something you'd serve at a backyard barbecue, natto is the ultimate breakfast of champions, and can be described as sticky fermented soybeans all strung together. You can make it by steaming soybeans until they're soft, and then introducing them into bacterium. After that, just simply let it ferment in hot and humid conditions for up to 24 hours. Often, it'll be served with soy sauce and take on an overpowering flavor along with a slimy texture. Mmm, yummy. It doesn't really sound too appealing, and that's because it isn't. Most that eat it religiously do admit that it doesn't taste good at all. However, it is a great source of vitamin K, fiber, protein, and iron. And even though people don't really enjoy it, they still eat it because it's good for them. Nankatsu. The word nankatsu sounds innocent enough, until you come to learn that it's actually fried chicken cartilage. Now, usually nankatsu is served on skewers, and you can find it in yakitori restaurants or Japanese pubs called izakayas. The taste is usually not the issue. In fact, most would say that it's pretty tasteless. Most often, it takes on the flavor of the sauce or the spice that you pick to go with it. It's the texture that most people can't seem to get around. And that's probably because it's not your usual average crispy chicken skin. It's rock hard and crunchy. People have said that it is comparable to the crunchiest part of a deep fried chicken wing, with one foodie saying that it even felt like you were munching on the chicken bones themselves. Yeah, you can count me out on this one. Inago no Tsukudani. If the idea of ultra-crunchy chicken cartilage hurts your teeth, how about a bowl of bugs? This popular Japanese dish consists of locusts that are boiled in soy sauce and sugar, which does sound kind of like the perfect combination of salty and sweet. However, the only issue is the teeny tiny legs that stick out of the bowl. The creation of this dish is rooted in perfect logic. Japanese farmers are constantly trying to keep locusts from damaging their crops. And because they swarm, they can easily destroy a lot of farmland in a very short amount of time. When this would happen in the past, Japanese citizens would be left with very little to eat, so they began eating the locusts because they're high in protein. After that, they began thinking to themselves, what better way to keep them away than to eat them before they even begin the attack? So I guess the redeeming quality of this dish is that you feel a little justified as you munch your way to the bottom of the bug bowl. Hachinoko and Zazamushi. Speaking of bugs, how about some deep-fried bee larvae, or a heaping serving of water bug larvae? Hachinoko is also called fried bee larvae and is often served in bars, much like peanuts are served in the good old-fashioned Wisconsin tavern. They're deliciously crunchy and sweet, so we've been told. They're fried with soy sauce and sugar, which is what gives them the pleasing, crispy texture. Of course, if you're craving something a little less crispy and a little more disgusting, then you should give zazamushi a try. Zazamushi means river bug larva, with zaza representing the sound that the river makes, and mushi translating to insect. Even better, zazamushi consists of any bug larva that inhabits the rocky riverbeds of Japanese rivers. So there's a good chance you're getting a lot of variety. Square watermelon. We end our list on a more delicious note, or at least one that doesn't make you want to toss your cookies. Now, is there really anything worse than a watermelon that keeps rolling around in the back of your car or even in your fridge? Initially, farmers began growing square watermelon because they're easier to stack, transport, and store. And as you know, Japan's very crowded, so the more space that they can save, the better. The square shape allows watermelons to be easily stacked in the trunk to be shipped to stores and markets. And in addition to that, Japanese refrigerators are a whole lot smaller than American ones. So the square watermelons fit a whole lot more easy and take up less beloved fridge space. To make a square watermelon, farmers place a tempered glass box around a small watermelon, and as it grows, it takes on the shape of the box. It does sound easy enough, however, they don't really come cheap anymore. Today, a square watermelon can cost an upwards of $200 or more. Oh, and if you want a designer melon, it could cost you $28,000. Rumor has it they don't even taste that great. So is the trendy fruit really worth the price tag? Probably not.
Toblerone bar. Now, if you've yet to experience the divine taste and texture of a Toblerone bar, you need to do it ASAP. But don't make the same mistake that everyone else does. Most people will just rip off a triangle in order to eat it, or just go at it open-mouthed. Either way can actually end up leaving you with a messy face or fingers. So, if you're one of those people, please stop doing that immediately.